Well, the great leader of France, Jacques Chirac, he says he'll unite all of Europe and give the United States and its economy a run for its money. Is he drinking too much of his own French wine? Time to go head to head. In London, we've got Philippe Legrain. He says that Chirac can absolutely bring Europe together and create a power that matches the U.S. He's the author of Open World, The Truth About Globalization. Philippe, I guess I just got to worry here because his record and certainly his economy doesn't show any signs of rivaling anyone.
Well, I didn't quite say what you introduced me as saying, but what I will say is that Europe's economy is now bigger than America's. And so what he's saying is quite true. You have to see that more of the top 500 companies in the world are European than American. You have to see that Germany alone exports more than the United States does. You have to see that more corporate bonds are now issued in Europe. Dollars, and you have to see that your currency, which used to be strong, is plummeting. So, I mean, there's quite a lot going for that thesis.
But, Philippe, you also have to see that the GDP of the countries in question is beneath that of our own, that the deficits as a percent of that GDP is higher than that of our own, that the growth is slower, that the union concentration, how that saps off the overall growth of the economies, is much higher than our own. So I'm looking at that and wondering what Jacques is smoking.
Well, I mean, you know, I'm not here to defend the French president. I'm here to say that, first of all, living standards in Europe are rising as fast as they are in America. The reason you have faster GDP growth is because you have a growing population. But if you actually look at how living standards are going, they're rising as fast in Europe as they are in America.
But the per capita, the per capita income gains in this country are twice as high. I'm not dismissing some of the improvement you're talking about, but let's get real on the overall numbers here.
If you'd like me to sort of actually have to be able to say something, the average European worker is as productive or more productive than the average American worker. And the reason why there's a gap in living standards is because as Europeans get richer, they choose to spend more of their time enjoying life with their family, playing tennis, rather than spending every hour God sends in the office. And that's a perfectly valid lifestyle choice. And, you know, the point of life is to be happy, not to be the richest man in the cemetery.
That's a very good point, but the fact of the matter is the savings, which many Europeans used to brag about a little more than three decades ago, is actually running below the U.S. now. So who's zooming home?
Well, you have a look at actually the position of the U.S. economy is unsustainable. You have an absolutely massive budget deficit. You have an even bigger current account deficit, which means that basically you're living on borrowed time. And, you know, no, I'm not saying the United States is destined fail any more than Europe is destined to fail, but it's complete nonsense to say that America is streets ahead and Europe is finished, because the facts simply don't show that.
All right, we'll respectfully disagree. Philippe, I want to thank you, though, very much. Appreciate it.